Welcome back, guys. This is Misty with the I Want to Know Christian Podcast, and I'm with the ever pleasant.
Here she goes.
Pastor
Get
Glinda.
It right, Pastor Glinda.
Pastor Glinda.
And you know what we're talking about today, Misty?
I don't know, but I bet you'll tell me.
Poverty mindset.
Poverty mindset. Man, a poverty mindset, not necessarily what you think it is.
Yeah.
You can be a rich person and have
a poverty mindset.
Yes, you can.
Mm-hmm.
So, Mom, why don't you tell us what a poverty mindset is? I mean,
well,
you would know, right?
Yeah. Well, I guess so, Misty. We all would probably know. We all should know. Poverty is a curse to begin with. Amen?
Amen, sister.
Even Psalms 34:10 says, even the strong young lions sometimes go hungry, but those who trust in the Lord will lack no good thing. What's the problem with people's mindsets about money, Misty?
Well, you're either somebody who has lots of money, but maybe you're just a miser with every penny, or you have no money and you just have a mindset that keeps you in
depression,
a state of poverty,
yes.
A state of lack.
Yes, yes. But what is it a lot of Christians have read in the Word of God and misinterpreted it?
Well, a lot of people think Jesus was poor.
Well, that too, but still, yeah, you're not getting where I want to go.
Well, honey, why don't you tell
me? The root of money, the scripture.
Oh, yes, the root of money. Well, a lot of scriptures in the Word of God are misquoted.
Yes.
The common one is money is the root of evil.
All evil, yes.
And that's not what was said.
I just read to you, if you trust in the Lord, it's a good thing.
Right.
If you use it the way God intends for you to use it, it's a good thing. Amen.
But as I said before, a lot of people thought Jesus was poor. Jesus was not
poor. He was not poor by
no means. Let me tell you, when, you know, you had three wise men come into your family with gold, frankincense, and myrrh back in the day, you would not be poor. He had his own accountant. It might have been a crooked accountant. But he had one.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
So, Mom, let's talk about the symptoms of a poverty mindset.
Oh, they're terrible.
You know, if you're somebody or you know somebody who has negative feelings about somebody who has money.
Yes.
There's a lot of people out there that are deeply jealous or resentful towards people that are wealthy.
Yes, 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 and I have seen that. I have seen people that way. But also, they believe money shouldn't be spent.
Mm-hmm.
Opportunities are limited as far as they're concerned.
Yeah, if there's something that comes up and it could be a good opportunity, there's immediately a reason why it's not going to work.
Yes, they're not going to.
You know that kind of person. You've experienced that kind of person. They're just so overly cautious.
Any risk is dangerous to them.
Right.
Well, what is faith, Misty?
What?
Faith means stepping out and taking risk. Amen?
Yeah. It gives substance to our hope.
Yeah. Success to them is only temporary.
Applying action.
Yeah.
I always said faith is an action word.
And you know, they kind of always remain in the back, Misty, mm-hmm. and in lack because they feel that's the safest place for them.
Right, and the other thing is, this is a big one, victim mentality.
Yes.
It's always the world.
Always
They've
the world.
They've been done wrong at every turn. Guess what? Who hasn't?
Right, right.
But
it's all inward, turned inward on them. Oh, poor, poor, pitiful me, you know. It ain't meant for me to ever have anything.
Right.
Oh, and then depression, oppression sets in. And they live a life. If you know, you may have the faith, oh my gosh, that moves mountains and that pleases God. But if you're married to somebody who doesn't, and especially if they're the head of the household, you're probably going to remain in lack all of your life,
mm-hmm.
and in trouble. You know, always, always. You know, and here's another thing. Their focus is always on what they don't have, Misty, not on what they do have. And that's Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You couldn't ask for better.
You know, it's not good to be unbalanced with money.
Yes.
In either direction.
Mm-hmm.
You know, either you're a person that has no respect for money, that's not seeking God, is leading a lifestyle. A lot of times you'll see people who live outside of their means, that live in tremendous amounts of debt.
Yes.
Because they're trying to keep up with somebody else.
Yeah, company.
Or you'll see a person who has lots of money in the bank, walks around, and they look like they just stepped off the street.
Yeah.
You know, because they're so fearful to spend anything. So remember, whew. Jesus, the Word of God is always about balance.
But all of these things we just talked about, every one of them is a poverty mindset. And if that's you, any one of them, you need to change your thinking. Amen?
You need to get some deliverance.
Yes, you need the Holy Spirit that to change mindset. Your thinking.
Because you know, you are a child of the living
yes.
God. You are joint heirs with Christ.
Hey, what does Psalms
Christ?
112 say, Misty? Psalms 112:3.
I don't know, but you're going to tell me.
Yes.
And you're going to interrupt
yes.
me and tell me. I know that
wealth
much.
And riches. This is Jesus. This is the Word of God. Wealth and riches shall be in His house. They themselves will be wealthy, and their deeds last forever. Why? Because they know what God wants them to do with the wealth He puts in their hand. He's the one that gives you that power to get wealth, the Bible says.
And remember, we're not talking about wealth for the purposes of being, you know, loving money and being, you know, all about living the
overly
lavish.
Well, we're in a faith project right now.
Right.
We are all, several of us are in a faith project in our church right now, mm-hmm. and we discussed this. Hey, if our hearts aren't not right towards what God wants done with His money, He's not going to bring it to us.
The main thing is you're putting the will of God first.
Yes, His
you're
plan.
Listening to that still small voice.
His plan, His purpose.
Because, you know, I don't want God to give me something that is not for my best interest.
Amen. There you said it.
And
there
I,
you
know,
said it.
I tell God, close those doors. Mm-hmm. I don't care what it is. I don't care how much money it is. I don't care how shiny and sparkly it looks on the surface. If it's not His will for me, then I trust God enough to keep it from me.
Yes, yes.
Don't give it to me.
Don't give it to us, Lord. No, no. If it's going to end up destroying us, we don't want it.
Right.
Which way would you choose, Misty? To have a poverty mindset or not a poverty mindset?
What kind of question is that, Mom?
there's
that's like asking me if I'd rather have, you know, cake or pie. I mean, it's like, of course I want cake. The main thing is that we're not caught up in what the will and the desires are of our heart.
Yes.
And we're all about...
And that's the problem, Misty, ain't it?
That ain't the pot calling the kettle black.
Woo! There she goes. I knew I'd get it out of her sooner or later. I said, Misty, you got to come up with something now. Come on. You know you're just over there thinking of something to get me with. And she just did it.
Well, you know what? You ain't coming back with anything good. So,
all right.
You know, somebody's
told you all about a lot of good.
You see what I'm working with.
Yes, well, you're doggone right. I have to keep her straight.
Anyway, it's not about what we want. It's about
what
God
wants. Amen.
And
it's
about
it.
Doing His work.
Yes.
During the short time that we have left.
And I mean, it's a short time, Miss Key.
Because there's nothing on this earth that holds any kind of precious value compared to what is waiting for us in heaven.
Yes. Well, we talked about that today. I said, Misty, I don't think we honestly know, oh my gosh, what we're going to have in heaven.
No.
The life we're going to have with Him.
It's unfathomable.
Yeah.
I mean, you know.
We talk about it. We know this and this and this and this. And the cities like this.
Cities of gold and precious gems and Mom living at least on the other side. You know, that's heaven to me, baby.
Yeah. Yeah, because I plan on, even if I have, when you see Misty, I can fly in heaven. I'll be able to just zap right over there, and I'll be at your doorstep every day.
Jesus ain't that cruel.
Oh, yes, He is. We'll be zapping all over the place. Just blink of an eye, we'll be there.
Yes, we will.
Yes, but you know what? You know, so many things hit us in our daily day, coming against us, and problems all the time, and this and that. But I'm just now getting my focus right on heaven.
About time.
On heaven.
About time you get this straight now.
I'm not thinking about this place no more. I'm thinking about heaven. Amen.
Girl, you need something. All right, guys. We appreciate you joining us for this episode of the I Want to Know Christian podcast. I'm probably going to get socked upside the head after this camera goes off.
Oh, you better believe it. You've been ornery.
Please. We will see you all next week with a brand new topic. And if there's anything that you would like to see us talk about, any questions, leave them down in the comment section below, and we will do our absolute best to answer them for you.
Yes.
All right, God bless you and keep you. And until next week, we will see you later.
Change your thinking.